A nigga gonna fuck you if you got a Michael Kors bag or if you got a Birkin.
But
a nigga's gonna fuck you if you in a Honda or if you in a Bentley. Those are not things being put forth by men as requirements. That's y'all competing with each other.
I don't think you're being honest. Men are attracted to a woman that's
niggas are fuck that. Why them girls not white? All of these girls that they look for on TV, none of them ever got a fucking ring. Everybody trying to emulate and who everybody trying to be, none of them got a stable household. None of them got families with kids and a man, and they out in Dubai as a couple. These same chicks that everybody trying to be in Dubai by their motherfucking self with the sheiks get pissing on them for 25 grand. Sheiks is making them fuck their kids for 50 grand. You don't see none of them girls with a man and a house. None of them same girls that we all want to be have that lifestyle. So y'all trying to find and emulate some shit that ain't even successful. Men not making no girl get no BBL.
Ever.
Chick is making themselves get a BBL to compete with what they think niggas like because of clicks on social media. This girl got 77,000 likes on social media. This skinny chick over here with a decent body got 7 likes. She happier than a motherfucker.
But do you think they do it because of the things they want?
They insecure. Insecurities are the biggest driving factor.
All right, this is the book of 1 Timothy. Chapter 5 and verse 6, and it says, but she that liveth in pleasure is dead while she liveth. I want to give all honor, all glory, and all praise unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Rakakwadash. Double honors to the elders of the nation of Israel. Shalom to you brothers out there that are laboring, enduring the elements, making your body a living sacrifice, trying to seal the elect, making your call and election assured, seeking out your own salvation. As well as you sisters that are learning, listening, applying, being obedient to your husbands. Shalom, shalom. Again, it's the brother Zachariah coming back to you with another lesson, all right, on this Saturday. And Lord willing to be edifying unto you. So without further ado, let's go ahead and dive into the lesson, all right? So, you know, I started off with 1 Timothy 5 and 6. Hey, but she that liveth in pleasure, okay? And we see that with a lot of these women, as you've seen in the video clip I put in the beginning. You know, Jake going into how, you know, these women out here thinking that, you know, having all these luxuries and things, you know, that's what a man want. But really, you said y'all competing with each other, like talking about woman to woman, which that's what it's all about. Okay. You know, back when I was in the world, I remember I used to go to a nightclub and these girls be dressing all provocative and stuff. And you thinking that, and they're not doing that for Jake. They in competition with the next female. They ain't studying Jake. There was a girl, two girls came in, and I knew one of the girls, and I went up to try to dance with her, and she's hugging up all on the girl that she was with. And I was like, damn, you know? That's the mindset of, you know, a lot of these women, all right? Even though, you know, the whole nightclub and stuff, you know, shouldn't even be nowhere near that. You know, it says I came into the truth. I'm done with that. But, you know, that's back in the world. But still, you know, you just look. I look back on those things and I was like, dang, you know, the women and stuff like that. And then they take these trips. They go all over the world and stuff. And really, when it's all said and done, he says, when you look, there's no ring on their finger. And there's no husband or nothing. You know, it's not a good look. All right. So it's like, okay, you know, what's really good? Like, what is this leading down? You know, at the end of the day, man, the blessing is really a woman to what? Have a man, a husband, okay? And not just any man, but a man of the Lord, okay? Because the Heavenly Father's not dealing with all men, okay? But he's dealing with the righteous, the meek of our people, the Israelites, you so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Native Americans, all right? You know, those men that gird up their loins like a man, you know, they're not conformed to this world. All right. Their standards of what a man should be. OK, because this world, if you leave it up to this world, this world's trying to turn the men into women. OK. Or they trying to go up in you, you know, if you know what I mean, trying to keep it clean. But, you know, hey, man, this place is through, man. Hey, and you know, call all your how about Shimmy out shot, man, for waking us up. All right. You know, bringing us into this truth. All right. And out of, you know, this dark and demented world, man, this perverted world. All right. So let me go ahead and get another precept. All right. We're going to go to the book of
First John chapter 2, I'm going to start at verse 15, and it says, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world, okay? You know, and ultimately, this is for all of us. You know, I'm saying this to all of us, but this message is really, this lesson is regarding the women, okay? Now, you know, hey, every now and then, hey, you have to do a lesson like this, you know? You know, I'm not the Jake that just all my lessons are solely on focus on women. No, because we got wicked Jakes too. And part of this lesson, yeah, we're going to bring out things on Jake as well. You know, because he said that, you know, these men, all they just want to do is just have sex with these women. They don't care whether what type of purse you have. And he's right. He's telling that he's absolutely right. You know, but not a man of the Lord don't think like that. But these, you know, we're not, I mean, of course, the man of the Lord is not care about that. But the woman that we're going to have, she's probably not even thinking about the fashions and things of this world. All right. You know, she's more of a meek, modest type woman. OK, she's not out here, you know, oh, let me get the you know, the freshest dress and our designer and all that. No, man, we just grateful to have what we have because we know we're going to get better when the kingdom comes. All right. But, you know, yeah, we're going to get on those men because those men that are running around sleeping with all type of women and not wifing them. Hey, that's considered a male whore. All right. Whoremonger, which we know the scriptures tell you, whoremongers won't inherit the kingdom either. All right. But again, 1 John chapter 2, starting at verse 15 says, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. See that? If any man love the world, all right, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, all right, and the lust of the eyes and the pride of life is not of the Father. See that? But is of the world. Okay, verse 17. And the world passeth away. Because we know that this old world is about done for. Okay. All right. It says, in the world passeth away and the lust thereof. All right. But he that doeth the will of God abideth forever. Okay. And the person that's doing the will of Yahweh Shem Yahshai is by way of keeping them law, statutes, and commandments. All right, you're seeking out your own salvation through fear and trembling. We're going out on the highways and hedges doing the work. You know what I'm saying? Bidding our people back to the marriage. You know, that of the elect. Okay? Things of that such, that nature. Okay? According to this word. You know, that's somebody that's doing the will of Yahweh Shem Yahshai. All right? So I just want to put that out there, okay? And there was another thing that he said in that video clip was that these women going over to Dubai and they're getting pissed on and crapped on by these sheiks and then paying them a certain amount of $1,000 to, you know, they land with their sons and stuff because the sheiks probably don't want to do it, but they'll let their kids do so because these women are nothing more but are prostitutes, okay? So, which I looked at another article I was looking at earlier, and they were going into it, talking about how you know, this stuff is a true. This thing really goes down. All right. And it says, Dubai porta potty. Influencers are apparently being pooped on for cash. That's crazy. That's a insane fetish. But see, that's what shows you that the Heavenly Father, it ain't just Esau. Heavenly Father ain't dealing with none of these nations. When you go into all these nations and their customs and the way that they live and they go about and their fantasies and the things they do, man, it's none of that stuff pertains to the Holy Bible, okay? The Bible is the way, okay? It's the way of life and the truth. All this other stuff, man, is just pure vanity. And you get and the Bible says you'll know them by their fruits, their works, the things that they do, all right? But it says if you've been blissfully unaware of the search term Dubai porta potty, consider yourself lucky. But if you're a morbidly curious individual who falls into dark internet rabbit holes during midnight scrolls, read on. This will be one of the strangest stories you've ever been told. It says last month video emerged on TikTok about a concept rumored to be real for years. Influencers being paid to fly out to Dubai in order to be pooped on or in for cash, get expensive gifts and experience extravagant hotel stays for free. One of the first people to make the story go viral was TikTok user Shinafar or something like that, which I remember this when this came out. Most of the TikToks that have followed are reactions or summaries from nine participants with some including clips of women who've worked as Dubai porta potties reading their contracts or sharing their experiences. Wow. One of the particular videos shows a 26-year-old woman reading out a contract nervously in which she consents to being flown to Dubai and getting a STD check to perform certain sexual acts on her client. Yep, Sultan Ali, all right, and have sexual acts performed on herself. The woman also says she'll be participating in sexual intercourse with a client's underage brother. Wow, see that? She adds that 2 weeks before she flies out, she'll receive $25,000 as a total of $50,000. The rest is paid once the job is complete. All right. Aside from this, there are also NFSW clips online showing women being defecated on, allegedly in the role of a Dubai porta potty. We will not be linking any of those. Absolutely. You may Google them, but be warned, everyone regrets Googling them. All right. And man, let's see, this right here says, so I got curious and searched up Dubai porta potty, and you know what she said? That's the last fucking straw. This is my 13th reason. I'm deactivating my whole fucking life. Bye. Wow, see that? I ain't gonna look it up either, all right, because I know, hey, that's insane. All right, but this is the book of Jeremiah chapter 31 and verse 22. It says, how long would thou go about, O thou backsliding daughter? For the Lord Yahweh have created a new thing in the earth. A woman shall compass a man. Okay? And that's the thing. A woman has risen above a man in this world, this rulership, this society, okay? Over the Israel, you know, the Israelite woman is even over the Israelite man, okay, which is out of order. Okay, now we know that the Israelite woman that's waking up to who she is, she's knowing her role and she's getting back in her position. Okay. Because as the scripture says, that the head of every woman is the man. Okay, so that's the real natural order of things. All right, but that's a curse that's put forth throughout the world, not just us, but just in general. Okay, and that's why you see so many divorces, single women. You know, it's terrible. Okay, and Esau Edom pushes it and promotes it more and more out here. Okay. So again, it says, how long would thou go about, O thou backsliding daughter? Okay, for the Lord have created a new thing in the earth. A woman shall compass a man. All right. So how long are you going to go about? All right. How long are you going to go about and you're taking these trips? You letting these people of these other nations, you know, piss and poop on you and stuff. Crazy, man. All right. But this is 1 Timothy 6 and 10. All that for money, though. All right. And it says, for the love of money is the root of all evil. See that? Which while some coveted after, they have erred from the faith. See that? And pierced themselves through with many sorrows. All right. So it's not good, man. All right. It ain't good. It's not a good look. All right. Yahweh Bashim Yahushua, man, is... He's exposing a lot of things in these last days, man. He's showing you more and more about the stuff that these women are doing. And that's why I'm not quick to just jump out here and be trying to, you know, oh, man, you know, trying to get you a woman and stuff. Especially if you're in this troop, you don't want, you know, we talk about Eve, the Israelite woman. But, hey, you know, and I'm saying as in the woman in this troop. All right. I'd rather have one in this truth than them one out there in the world, because you don't know what they've been doing. You could be trying to like, oh, I'm going to get me one out in the world, and you get one in the world and she's probably done this. You know, you letting these other nations do these things for you. Ain't no telling what she'll do for a piece of change. Okay, so I'm gonna read this again. For the love of money is the root of all evil, which while some coveted after, they have erred from the faith. Okay. And pierced themselves through with many sorrows. Yeah, it's going to be many sorrows, more to come, because, hey, it's going to be a economic collapse of the dollar. All right. What you going to do then? You know, it's going to come a time where you're not going to be able to travel and go place to place. You ain't going to be able to take them to buy trips. All right. It says that a man shall desire to go into a city and shall not be able. That's in 2 Ezra. All right, 15 chapter, verse 17. All right. So you're going to have a lot of these things, okay? This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 23 and verse 17. It says, there shall be no whore of the daughters of Israel. Okay, these such acts, doing these such things. Heavenly Father's not dealing with that, okay? There's not gonna, it shouldn't be no whores of the daughters of Israel, nor a sodomite of the sons of Israel, okay? Which I, you know, that's not the topic of this lesson, but however, I did do a recent lesson going into that. You know, you got pastors out here talking about this is my husband and stuff. Male pastors talking about this is my husband. Man, that's out of order, man. All right, that just shows you more and more how the Heavenly Father is not dealing with these churches. It makes more sense when you go into the scriptures and he tell you that, hey, he dwelleth not in temples made with hands. Because look what's going on in these temples. Okay? Yahweh Shemiah Shai, man, is showing more and more why he ain't dealing with her. Okay? So again, it says, there shall be no whore of the daughters of Israel, nor a sodomite of the sons of Israel. All right? All right, this is the word whore. It says whore meaning, and look what pops up. Prostitute. You know, because what was those girls doing? They were doing sexual acts for money. And that's what this, what you go into the word whore or prostitute. That's what it means. All right. And I got the definition here. It says somewhat old fashioned, but it says a person who engages in sexual intercourse. See that? For pay. And that's what they've done. Okay. Look, you got the word prostitute. It says, all right. It says offensive, but it says a promiscuous or immoral woman. All right. Heavenly Father's not dealing with that. Hey, this place, America is known as what? The Whore of Babylon. All right. Babylon the Great, the Whore of Babylon, that great whore. Because they push the vibration. They push this vibration. Okay. On all women, these other nations as well. They come over and they get tapped into this as well. You know, they have their own ways and customs, and then they come over here and then they change all up. Okay. Babylon has been a golden cup in the Lord Yahweh Bashim Yahusha's hand, man. Okay? But doing all that stuff for that money, man, is all vanity. This is Proverbs 11 and 4. It says, riches profit not in the day of wrath, but righteousness delivereth from death. Remember how it says, she that lives in pleasure is dead while she liveth? Okay? You know, that's that term, dead man walking, dead woman walking, I guess you could say in this case. You know? But it says, riches profit not in the day of wrath. Okay, all that money, it don't mean nothing. I was talking about that a little bit earlier in my lesson. You know, all that don't mean nothing. Okay? It says, riches profit not in the day, all right, of wrath, but it says, but righteousness delivered from death. All right? So you want to, you know, get yourself, you know, you want to depart from all those things. All right? This is Colossians chapter 3 and verse 2. It says, set your affection, all right, set your affection on things above, not on things of the earth, okay? Let's see. Yeah, I don't know about that scripture, but yeah, set your affection on things above, okay? Which are things above? We know that the things above us is what? The heavenly realm, okay? That's where we are laying our treasures as well, as I was talking about in my lesson, all right? Setting your treasures up and, you know, laying them up in the heavenly realm. Okay, we don't care about the things of this world. All right, you know, now we have actually, you know, what I'm saying, we're building our treasures up there. You know, we come out here, we work, we get our daily bread and stuff. But at the end of the day, you know, we don't have the cares of this world. We're not trying to live it up to the fullest. Okay, this place is on its way out. All right, so that's the type of mindset, all right, you want to have. All right, and this is and like I said, with this place being more and more, you know, it's on its way out. Look at this. This is from Fortune. All right, and it says more American women are single than ever. Wonder why. Just like the brother was saying in the video clip. Okay, it says, and it's costing them big money. Absolutely, cost of living is ridiculous, man. Okay, it's best to be like a, you know, a couple. You know, and here I am in this truth, and I'm not married. You know, I'm a eunuch, you know, in this thing, you know. So I've just focus on the ministry and doing the work of Yahweh Shemiah Shah, because there are certain men in this thing that were disciples, that were eunuchs, and we just restrain from all of it and just focus on just doing the work. Okay, you got guys that will make fun of you because of that and stuff like that, but the Heavenly Father's not dealing with them kind of guys. I don't care if they know this truth or they do it, they're in this truth. If they making fun of you for that reason, the Heavenly Father's not dealing with them guys. Okay,
Absolutely, because you would understand, because when you making fun of that, you making fun of our forefathers, you making fun of our disciples, you making fun of Yahweh Bashim Yahusha, and he is not mocked, okay? Whatever a man sow, a man will reap, all right? But some men have given that up to focus on solely on just doing this work. You know the true importance of it. In the city I'm in, you don't know, man. You liable to catch something dealing with some of these females out here. So I just focus on just doing the work, all right? Because whatever I give up on this end, the Heavenly Father is going to bless me, all right, in the kingdom, okay? And some may get that blessing before, because, you know, we know there's the Isaiah 4:1 prophecy, all right? And in that day, the Heavenly Father is not going to send somebody, you know, full of diseases on you, because mostly, more than likely, they're probably going to go down with this place, you know? But the Heavenly Father is going to bless you. You're going to know that it comes from Yahweh Shimei Yahusha. Now, some men can get a blessing right now, all right? If you're in this truth and you are seeking that woman, you know, right now, hey, the Heavenly Father could very well give you that, you know. That's very possible, okay? But you got a lot of these women out here, man. It's crazy. And you just want to be very, very careful with that, all right? So, again, it says more American women are single than ever, and it's costing them big money. Yep, rent, food, you know. Some of these jobs are cutting back. You know, you're cutting back hours. They're not paying like that. Everything is insane. You know, I didn't feel like cooking, so I went out and just got myself a sandwich. All right. And that bad boy came up to $19, man. I was like, what the hell? I said, for $19, I could have cooked the whole dinner. You know, that was crazy. And it probably wouldn't even cost me that. You know, just showing you, man, the times that we are in, man. All right. It's very, very expensive. Okay, so it says next time Beyonce asks for all the single ladies to put their hands up, there may be a bigger crowd than you think. That's crazy. It says nearly 118 million Americans, or about 46% of those over 18 years old are single. Wow, that's crazy, according to the U.S. Census Bureau. But that percent is actually much higher for women. A record-breaking 52% of them are unmarried or separated as of 2021. Damn, according to a recent report from Wells Fargo Economics, okay? And another thing, if you don't know, I've done the research looking into it, and you'll find out that as far as religions go, the more divorce rate is so much higher with the religion of Christianity. Okay, how they talk about Christianity and talk about these other religions. Well, they have the biggest divorce rate, you know. So what's really good when it comes to that? All right. So it's crazy. But that's all I'm going to read on this article. Y'all can read the rest of that on your own time. But, hey, we know that our time is going to be like never before. You know, I told what it was saying earlier, you know, many sorrows and stuff are going to come. All right, this is Jeremiah 30:7. It says, alas, for that day is great, all right, so that none is like it is, even the time of Jacob's trouble. See, so this is what it's coming. It's Jacob's trouble, okay? But he shall be saved out of it. And we know that that's talking about the remnant, the elect of the nation of Israel, you so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Native Americans, okay? All right, that's who that's talking about. And we also know that Yahweh Bashim Yahusha is going to make a man that has been trodden down, okay? You know, an Israelite man that has been beaten, trodden down, overlooked. You know, all the women, they won't look at that. Oh, I ain't looking at him. He ain't got no money, or he ain't got no car, or he ain't got this, he ain't got that. You know, but you're looking, you know, you're looking at these other guys who ain't no good, you know? That's what you look at a high value man. Meanwhile, the high value man may not have all those things, but he has this word, man, and that's everything. It trumps all this stuff in this world, even the so-called money and stuff and power. All right. Well, you know, he's going to make that man more precious than fine gold. And to go along with that, this is Isaiah 32:2. It says, and a man shall be as a hiding place from the wind. Because we know during Jacob's trouble, it's going to be wars, famines, destruction, all right, that nuclear destruction, all right, which is talking about that a little bit here, okay? And a man shall be as a hiding place from the wind, all right, and a covert from the tempest, as a river, as rivers of water in a dry place, all right, as the shadow of a great rock in a weary land, all right? And he's going to be that protection in those days, okay? So if you don't have that, it ain't going to be a good thing for you. I told you that a lot of these women are going to be, I'm going to use the proper word, ravish. Okay, you look that word up and you'll see what I'm talking about. R-A-P-E, if you know what I mean. I try to watch my words on here because it be trigger words, You know, the elders have said sometimes you got to speak in code on this thing, or use maybe proper words instead of certain words that, you know, trigger words from your lessons, okay? But this is the book of Sirach, chapter 36 and verse 25. It says, where no hedge is, okay, that hedge of protection, that's going to be that man, okay? Where no hedge is, there the possession is spoiled. And he that have no wife will wander up and down mourning like, damn, you know, because, hey, a lot of these women, men are going to be put down, okay? But there are going to be a lot of women that are going to be delivered too, you know? It says, it tells you in the scripture that a lot of these women are going to be saved through childbearing, okay? Because we know that Isaiah 4 and 1, you know, when a woman says, hey, man, they're going to cleave unto that one man and say, hey, let us... you know, matter of fact, listen, let me go ahead and get it real quick, because that's a beautiful, I don't want to butcher it. All right, this is the book of Isaiah, chapter 4 and verse 1. It says, and in that day, seven women, which seven is symbolic, it means completion, okay? And in that day, seven women shall take hold of one man. They're going to take hold of one man, okay? You see that? For all those, oh, it's just the, you know, one woman, one man, and all that. Now, I understand, hey, so certain situations, yeah. Okay, this might not be for everybody. Every, you know, in those days, hey, that don't mean seven women's gonna cleave to every single Israelite man. All right, but this is a prophecy, and whether you like it or not, okay, you gotta get out of your feelings when it comes to this truth. And if you think that, oh, well, not on my watch, or this and that ain't gonna take place, well, then who says you're gonna get salvation? You know, the Heavenly Father might destroy you. All right, just because you know you an Israelite, don't guarantee your salvation. You know, don't let that go over your head. You know. Hey, I'm my type of spirit that's on me is whatever the Heavenly Father's will, let it be done. All right. You know, never, you know, who cares about my feelings and all that, man, they ain't stopping none of that. You know, whatever he has for me, because he has the best plan. Okay. That's my type of mindset. But this is Isaiah 4:1 says, and in that day, seven women shall take hold of one man, saying, we will eat our own bread and wear our own apparel. Only let us be called by thy name. And we know that only way that a woman can be called by that man's name is by that man marrying them. And we know the whole, we know according to the scriptures of how marriage really is, okay? It's a man going unto that woman, and that woman becoming one with him, all right? Okay? It says, only let us be called by thy name to take away our reproach. And when you go into the word reproach, it's like, it means shame, okay? The shame of not believing, the shame of trusting in the shadow of Egypt, you know, which it tells you that it will trusting in this place, America, is going to be your shame and your confusion. Okay, so you have that. All right, that's prophecy. Okay, so let's go back up to this again. It says, where no hedge is, all right, there the possession is spoiled. Okay, and he that have no wife will wander up and down mourning. Okay, so now you see that. All right. And like I said, where no hedge is, for those, all right, that are going to laugh, scoff, they talk shit. There's people that talk shit about, you know, us bringing out this truth on social media and things like that. You know, it's okay, because we know, hey, it ain't for everybody. And they think that they got away, or they thinking, oh, they got it, or, they, you know, see, you know, I don't believe all that. Hey, we know the Bible says you'll die in your unbelief. All right. This is Micah 7 and 10. It says, then she that is my enemy, okay, shall see it. So there's going to come a time where they're going to see it. You know, Ezekiel 33 and 33 says you're going to know that a prophet had been among you. All right. And that could ultimately be when you being destroyed. All right. And it says, in shame, there's that word shame again, and shame shall cover her. Okay. Which said unto me, where is the Lord thy God? See that? My eyes shall behold her. You're going to see it. Now shall she be trodden down as the mire of the street. So she's going to be destroyed. And it could happen before your very eyes. In those last days, when all hell's breaking loose, we might see a lot of people that have talked shit and came up against us, watching them being put to death. Because you're gonna be, when we on the move and we're staying moving, because you know this devil gonna come down with great wrath. Like I said, you might come across all kinds of bodies laid out. You're gonna see some, you know, before they give up the ghost, and they look up and see you, and they just bloody where somebody done went upside their head or something. All right, and as they've been destroyed, man. Hey, it's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. But for you women that have eyes to see and ears to hear, all right, this is for you. This is Jeremiah 6 and 2. It says, I have likened the daughters of Zion to a comely and delicate woman. Okay? So y'all that are waking up and making the change, okay? Because see, hey, we bring out the bad, the good, and the ugly, all right? You know, I gave you the bad and the ugly, okay? But here's some good, all right? This is what the Heavenly Father sees his daughters of Zion, all right? Okay? I have likened the daughter of Zion to a comely and delicate woman, okay? This is 1 Timothy 2 and verse 9. It says, in like manner, also the women adorn themselves in modest apparel, okay? See that? Not showing your breasts hanging out, showing your body figure and all that kind of stuff, real short, because you know a lot of times, you know, they'll say, well, look, I'm wearing a dress, but hey, not all dresses are modest. You got some that are showing the body off, all right? So you know, The women that are in very modestly apparel, not showing everything, not revealing everything, okay? So again, it says, in like manner, also the women adorn themselves in modest apparel with shamefacedness, see that? In sobriety, not with broided hair or gold or pearls or costly array, okay? Verse 10, it says, but which becometh women professing godliness with good works. Yeah, doing good works, man. Hey, man, because, hey, you sit, Bible says you'll know them by their fruits, which is their works. Okay, this is the book of Ephesians chapter 5, starting at verse 22. It says, wives, see that, wives, like how that guy was saying, he don't seeing no wives and things like that. Yep, even with these celebrities, you're not seeing they're not seeing them with husbands, okay? Because that's the type of vibration that's being pushed, all right? Even if they are married, eventually they end up in divorce, okay? But here it says, wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands, all right, as unto the Lord. See that? For the husband is the head of the wife, like I said earlier, even as Christ is the head of the church. See that? All right. And he is the savior of the body. Woo! Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. So you need that husband, man. It's very important. All right. Marriage is a beautiful thing. Okay. So with that, this is Hebrews 13 and 4, and I'll go ahead and end it on this. Lord willing, this has been an edifying lesson too, by the way, okay? Like I said, I'm in the spirit. I feel good. You know, my allergies was acting up. I had trouble breathing. That's why I wasn't able to do my lessons the last 2 days. But, you know, I didn't want to make no excuse, nothing. I just, hey, whatever I got to do to get myself right and come up. And this morning, I felt kind of iffy, but I don't know what it was. It's like the Heavenly Father. I despite all that, I got up. I said my prayers this morning, my daily prayers, which I pray to him every morning, face the east, all right? And then next thing you know, I came out. I was preparing my lesson. I said, I'm going to go ahead and knock out a lesson. And as I'm out here absorbing the sun, I just felt good, man. And then I came back in, you know, because it is hot out here. It's hot out here right now. But, whew, but hey, I ain't tripping. I'm just absorbing the sun, and I feel good, man. You know, I thought I'm getting sick and stuff like that. My nose was stopped up. I had to start blowing my nose. And because, you know, it's coming into the change of seasons, which it usually gets me every year. But Lord willing, man, I don't go through that. Maybe I can make that transition from summer to fall and be all right. But I feel good right now. So Lord willing, man, hey, I'll just keep coming out, knocking out these lessons. All right. Who knows? I might upload like like 5 or 6 of them today, you know, which that could be like a record. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, that's not counting the highways, you know. Hey, I still got to go out and do my highways today, which I got some good stuff, man, I'm going to be bringing out. All right. And so, Lord willing, that be edifying unto you. But Lord willing, this lesson here has been edifying. All right. You know, it's just showing you a way of how you should conduct yourselves. Okay. You women, man, because, hey, you're going to play a part in this kingdom as well. You know, y'all are leaders as well. You know, you are to be examples to the other women. Okay. Even these women of the other nations, because we are going to go out and teach these other nations. Okay. All right. Just like the Bible says, you women can teach other women. All right. And the children. So if that's the case of our fellow Israelite people, when we begin to govern over this earth, all right, in the new heaven, the new earth that's going to be established here. All right. That's still going to apply whenever we start teaching the other nations, because we got to teach them the ways of Yahawashim Yahushua. Okay. All right. So with that, all right, this is Hebrews 13 and 4. It says marriage is honorable. Okay. All right. It's honorable. All right.
in all, in everything, okay? In the bed, undefiled. See that? Don't have all these different men laying, you know, laying with you, because you know that's there's information that tell you that, hey, you know, when you lay with all these different men, that DNA gets stored in you, okay?
I was today years old when I found out.
I'm gonna share this article with you about how women absorb and retain the male DNA from the sperm of every single man that she's ever slept with. A scientific study has shown that females retain and carry male DNA from every sexual encounter with men. Okay? Every sexual encounter.
So again, marriage is honorable in all, in the bed undefiled, but whoremongers, like remember I said earlier here, a whoremonger is a male whore, okay? And adulterers, God will judge, and they will not enter to the kingdom, all right? So if you ever lived that lifestyle, you ever done it knowingly or unknowingly, hey man, repent, come back to Yahweh Shem Yahushua while you still have the chance to do so, okay? And Lord willing, man, this lesson has been edifying unto you, okay? And that we all be on those chariots, man. Okay? So I want to give all honor, all glory, and all praise unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Rakakwadash. Double honors to the elders of the nation of Israel. And Shalom to you, brothers and sisters out there. Until the next one, Shalom.